Hello everyone, a very good evening to all of you. Wish you all a Merry Christmas. I hope your holidays are going great. All right. So we will very quickly begin with today's lecture. Okay, in the initial 10 to 15 minutes, we will revise a grammar topic that we have already done. And we are going to discuss an assignment of the same. All right. Moving on, I want you guys to tell me which writing skill or a grammar topic we have not covered yet. So is there any topic that is pending that is done in your school and that is not being taught here? So very quickly, please tell me what is left and what, you know, do you need help in? Okay. Yes, we are going to do the question assignment. All right, so if you have written down that assignment, please open your books. We will discuss it. All right, guys, you can message me in the account of Rajvi Thakkar. Okay, message me there. Yeah. So, as per the majority, there are three topics which are not done. Okay. So, yeah. So, as per my calculations and whatever I've read, according to your suggestions, there are three topics that we have not done. The first one is view counter view. The second is clauses, the subordinate clause and types of the same. And the third is summary writing, all right? 4.2 is left, I know, but that is what we can schedule later on in the holidays itself. But we can, yeah, because I don't think all of the schools must have that topic, okay? Yeah. Okay. So, according to the time constraint today, I feel view and counter view is a very good choice and option today. So we will do that. All right. So now very quickly, let me share the assignment with you. I hope you guys can see my screen now. Okay. To give you a brief, question tag is a short question which is asked at the end of a statement to see whether the listener confirms or agrees to whatever is said. All right. Now, what we generally do is question tag comprises of two words. Okay. The first word is always an auxiliary verb, that means your helping verb, and the second word is your pronoun. It always works like that. First your helping verb, the second is your pronoun. All right, whenever an auxiliary verb is not present in the sentence, we use do, does or did. Another important rule is that if the statement is affirmative, we make it a negative and vice versa. That is, if it is negative, the question tag is affirmative. Very clear with this, guys? Okay. So can you tell me the answer of the first one? Your efforts were futile. Now here we do have... Okay, so your answer should be in complete sentence. Okay, so you have to write your efforts were futile, put a comma, write down those two words, the question tag, and then put a question mark. If you do not put a question mark, your marks will be deducted. So please don't make that mistake. Even while you are typing, you are telling it to me. Please add a question mark at the end. All right. Acha, this one was a very simple one. Your efforts were futile. Now here there is an auxiliary verb. Okay, so all of those have returned didn't they? Or have I? Beta, have I kaise aayega? It's incorrect. The correct answer to the first question is weren't they? Weren't they? WERE'T, they question mark. All right. Since were is present in the question, in the statement, you use the negative version of that. All right. Okay, moving on. Second one. I have no intention to hurt anyone. A tricky question here. Which is your main verb here? Please identify the main verb here, the helping verb here. Okay, so you have one verb, correct? Have. I have no intention to hurt anyone. Now, to hurt is your infinitive, that is your non-finite verb. You have only one verb. Whenever there is a single verb in your sentence, that verb naturally, automatically becomes your main verb. It means that here we do not have an auxiliary verb. And my have is functioning as a main verb here. And since have is not an auxiliary verb in this sentence, we have to use do, does, or did. Because listen to this very properly. I have no intention to hurt anyone. Have I? Is it sounding correct to you? No. No. Have I any intention? No. Do I have any intention of hurting anyone? Okay, so it is do. I have no intention to hurt anyone. Do I? Okay, so the correct answer to this question is do I, not don't I. The statement is negative, guys. I have no, N-O-no. All right. Does I will not come because it is have. If it was has, okay, then does aata. Theek hai? Next one. It is necessary to put your best foot forward. Easy one, come on. Very good, guys. The correct answer is, isn't it? The I of isn't should be small. There should be an apostrophe between N and T. And at the end, you have to put a question mark, all right? So yes, so the correct answer is, isn't it? It is necessary to put your best foot forward, isn't it? Come on, moving on. I remember the happy days of my childhood. Fourth one. I remember the happy days of my childhood. Now in this sentence, I do not have an auxiliary verb. I is the subject. Remember is the main verb here. You do not have anything. So you have to use from do, does or did. Now the issue is do, did nahi aayega kyunki past tense nahi hai. Whenever your sentence is in past tense, it is did, but it is not. Okay. Now, whenever your main verb has S at the end of it, she remembers. So doesn't she? I remember, don't I? Very clear. Everybody who has written doesn't. Guys, you are incorrect. Please listen to this explanation. She remembers, doesn't she? I remember, don't I remember? ऐसा होता है, ठीक है? तो don't I. Very clear with this one? Okay, moving on. There was no response despite several reminders. Fifth one, come on. There was no response despite several reminders. Okay. Wasn't नहीं आएगा because the statement is negative. There's a word no, no response. Okay. Yes. So the correct answer is was there. There was no response despite several reminders. Was there is the correct answer. Okay. Next. It isn't a good idea to consult him. Very good, guys. Everybody till now has answered it correctly because it is an easy one, right? It isn't. Isn't is already there. So I have to make it opposite. Negation nikalna hai. So is it is the correct answer. I repeat. It isn't a good idea to consult him, comma, is it? All right, moving on. Seventh one. We aren't aware of his problems. We aren't aware of his problems. Do we have an auxiliary verb here? Yes, we do have. Aren't is there. It is present in the sentence. It is negative. You have to make it affirmative. So are we? Very good, guys. Very good. Excellent. We aren't aware of his problems, comma, are we? Question mark. If you are making any mistakes, please focus your... Okay, next one. This event will give the school the recognition it deserves. This event will give the school the recognition it deserves. This event is the subject. Will give is your verb here. Okay. Will ka kya hota hai beta? Wouldn't is incorrect. Willn't is not the verb that we use, guys. So whenever you want to put will into negation, it will be won't. W-O-N apostrophe T. Please listen to this very properly now. Would ka wouldn't hota hai. Will ka won't hota hai. Theek hai? So it is won't. This event will give the school. Won't it. Won't this nahi aayega. Okay. Won't it. Question mark. Okay. Next one. The aquarium houses a wide variety of fish. Now focus on the do, does, did rule that I have asked you. Here the aquarium is subject, houses is the main verb. The correct answer is doesn't it. See, houses. Verb ke piche s hai. Correct. So it will be doesn't. The entire sentence is affirmative. So the question tag will be negative. So the correct answer is doesn't it. Clear with this? Next, you needn't to waste your time. Oh, need you nahi aayega. Do you is the correct answer here. You need not waste your time. Do you need to waste your time? No. So do you is the correct answer here. We do not use need as an auxiliary verb. All right. In the question tag. Very, very clear with this one. Next. We can't compromise on our values. Easy one. Can we is the correct answer. Very good. So, we can't compromise on our values. Can we? Very good. Next one. He was disappointed when the results were declared. Another easy one. He was disappointed. Wasn't he? The correct answer is, wasn't he? Next. Rama and Rajesh did their best. Very good, guys. Very good. Rama and Rajesh did their best, didn't they? Since our subject is plural, we need to use they. So didn't they? Very good, guys. Okay, 14th one. You must master the basics first. Excellent. The correct answer to the 14th one is, mustn't you? Ride on MUST must N apostrophe T. A lot of students have written MUSNT. Don't write that. MUST N apostrophe T, mustn't you, is the correct answer. Okay. Okay, moving on. The last one. The moon adds to the beauty of the night sky. Sky at night, whatever. The moon adds to the beauty. The moon is your subject. Adds is your main verb here. Uske piche s hai, and you don't have an auxiliary verb. Yes, so the correct answer is, doesn't it? Okay, the moon adds to the beauty of the sky at night, doesn't it? Excellent, guys, excellent. So here we have cleared the part. Yes, it because it is a non-living thing. Yeah. Okay, so I hope this exercise is very, very clear to you. And the concept of question tag is, you know, very easy for you now. All right. Give me a moment. The answer to the 10th one is, you need not waste your time. Do you? Do you is the correct answer. Okay. The answer to the 9th one is, the aquarium houses a wide variety of fish, doesn't it? All right, guys. So now we are going to begin with a very, very interesting grammar topic. All right. Give me a second. Okay, am I audible to you? Okay, guys. Yeah. So, no, we are not going to do view and counter view because one, I couldn't find the PPT, and second, since we have quite some time right now, we will do the basics of clauses, and then we will move ahead and do the types today very quickly. Okay, come on. So before we begin clauses, there are two things that we need to clear, the basics first. Okay, now what are we going to see is first, the revision of your finite and non-finite verbs. And the second basic that we are going to clear is about the definition of clauses. Okay. Yes, you guys can message me in the account of Rajvi Thakkar. Okay. Yes, come on. So very quickly, what is the major difference between a finite and a non-finite verb? We have already done this. Come on, tell me. What is the difference between finite and non-finite verbs? If you need to understand clauses, you need to understand this very well first. Okay, very, very good. So, finite verb have subject, or we can add non-finite subject. Okay. So the most common and correct answer that you have told me, and the very important part actually, is that a finite verb shows you tense, non-finite does not show you the tense. I repeat, finite verb tells you the time of the action. It tells you when the action has occurred or will occur, or it basically tells you the time of the action. Okay, non-finite verb will not tell you the time. Very, very clear with this. Now we had an easier way of identification of the same, for which we said that finite verb ke exactly pehle the subject is either present or possible. Okay, so if the subject is present or it is possible to put a subject exactly before the finite verb, exactly before the verb, that verb becomes your finite verb. And if that is not possible, it is your non-finite verb. In sense, non-finite verb के पहले subject डालना मुश्किल ही नहीं, नामुमकिन होता है. Okay, yeah. So basically, the point of understanding here is that finite verbs, they do not, sorry, they show you the tense, and non-finite will not show you the tense. Is this very, very clear? Okay, let's see. So as we discussed, subject is possible before the verb, no subject possible before the verb. So we have done this example, I believe. Dhruv laughed and jumped. Please pick out the verbs in this sentence. Laughed and jumped. Very good. Now tell me if both of these are non-finite, finite, one of them is non-finite, finite, whatever. Come on. Okay, let us see. Laughed here in this sentence, laughed के exactly पहले क्या है? ध्रुव. Now, ध्रुव is a subject, correct? It is either a noun or a pronoun. So, laughed naturally becomes your finite verb. Jumped के पहले क्या है बेटा? And है. And क्या है? Conjunction है. So, does it become your non-finite verb? Does the verb jumped become non-finite? Let us see. What do we have to do? We have to check. For checking, what do we have to do? We have to add a subject just before that verb. So can I say that Dhruv laughed and he jumped, or Dhruv laughed and Dhruv jumped? Is it okay? Now, is the sentence making sense to you? Is it still making sense? Yes. So, even though the subject is not actually present, but it is possible to put a subject just before your verb. So, both of these verbs are your finite verbs. Very clear with this? Okay. Now let us look at another one. Yes, laughed and jumped, both they show simple past tense. Okay, yeah, so moving on. While running, he fell. Pick out the verbs here. Very good, running and fell. Okay, let us check. What do you think? Fell is a finite or a non-finite? Let us discuss that first. Okay, fell के पहले exactly ही है. He subject है. So whenever subject is possible before the verb, or subject is there before the verb, that verb naturally becomes a finite verb. Very clear with this? Now let us look at running. Okay. अच्छा, रनिंग के पहले है वाइल, विच इज अ सबऑर्डिनेटर. लेट अस से इट इज अ कंजंक्शन. ओके, कैन आई पुट इट वाइल ही रनिंग ही फेल? वाइल ही रनिंग ही फेल. इज द सेंटेंस मेकिंग सेंस टू यू गाइस? नो नो, इट इज नॉट. सो सिंस आई कैन नॉट इवन एड अ सब्जेक्ट बिफोर द वर्ब, that verb becomes non-finite verb, all right? So this is a very clear explanation. Now listen to this very properly. Now, when do we use the ing words? We use it generally in your continuous tense. Okay, so if the sentence would have been, listen to this very clearly. am running, is running, was running, will be running. अगर ये कोई भी वर्ब्स होते, ये कोई भी ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स होते तो रनिंग का टाइम दिखता. करेक्ट. तो रनिंग का टाइम दिखता, वॉज रनिंग पहले, अभी इज रनिंग या विल बी रनिंग. बट विदाउट दीज, रनिंग इंडिपेंडेंटली कैन नॉट शो यू द टाइम ऑफ द एक्शन. वेरी क्लियर विद दिस वन? Okay, all right. So, finite verb, it shows you the tense and subject is possible. Non-finite does not show you the tense and subject is impossible before it. Very clear with this? Okay, moving on. We have cleared one very important part in this topic, okay? And you will understand why this is so very important. Okay, come on, moving on. Now, tell me what is the definition of a sentence. See, we have been doing sentences and phrases like since in fifth standard ka pehla topic tha, sentence and phrase. So do you remember the definition or what is a sentence, what is a phrase, and we will come on to what is a clause. Okay, come on, very quickly. Acha, somebody said a group of meaningful word is called a sentence. Next, group of words which make complete sense, a group of words that make sense. Okay, formation of words, meaningful combination of words, meaningful words combined together. Okay. Now listen to this. Sentence is a group of words. ऐसा नहीं बोलते बेटा, meaningful words. Meaningful words तो definitely, ये तो obvious चीज हो गया. No, a group of words that make complete sense. The word complete is very, very important here. Okay, so sentence is a group of words that make complete sense. Okay, let us see. Pankaj eats sweets. Does Pankaj eat sweets? Please get me some water. What a beautiful painting it is. Now here we have showcased you all the four different kinds of sentences, correct? Okay. Kaushiki, my dear, please do not go into sentence clause right now. Let us only understand what is a sentence, okay? We will definitely come to the relationship between a clause and a sentence. But for now, let us see this, okay? So yeah, we have understood that sentence is a group of words जिसका complete sense बनता है. Okay. Now do one thing. I want one thing from you. All of these sentences, if you must have noticed, it contains a verb. Okay. Tell me if they are finite or non-finite. Quickly. Check. Okay, eats in the first one is finite because uske pehle Pankaj hai. Correct. Very good. Eat in second one is also finite because does or eat ko saath mein kar diya, so it definitely shows you the tense. Does eat is simple present tense. Very good. Okay, third one, get. Is it a finite or non-finite? It is finite because it is showing me the tense. The tense is simple present tense. And by the way, how do I know it? Okay. Here the subject is not present. But can I add it? You get me some water. Is it making sense? You get me some water. Okay, so yes, it is a finite verb. Next, it is. Your is also the finite verb. Okay. Yeah. Now, frame a sentence without a finite verb, because all of these sentences, they do have a finite verb. Please frame a sentence without a finite verb. Come on. Acha. Somebody told me, I love to dance. Isme finite verb hai, beta? I love to dance. Love hai na? I love. Love ke pehle kya hai? I. Subject hai. Toh wo finite verb ho gaya. I want a sentence without a finite verb. By laughing, she fell. Fell hai na? Fell ke pehle she hai. Swimming is my hobby mein is kya hai? He likes swimming. Likes. Are you a girl? Are. Finite hai. Because isko, if you make it an assertive sentence, you are a girl. My hobby is swimming. So is kya hai? He would love to dance. Would love. What is would love? It is finite verb. Okay. So yes, as most of you pointed it out correctly, it is, guys, enough. Enough. It is not possible to frame a sentence without a finite verb. Great. Okay. Guys, stop messaging me, please. Okay, here we understand that. Listen to this very properly. You cannot frame a sentence in English language without a finite verb. It is impossible to frame a sentence without a finite verb. So, yes, a sentence is a group of words that make complete sense and it does have a finite verb in it. Okay, very clear with this one. So you can just write it down. If you want to note it down somewhere, sentence, it is a group of words that make a complete sense and it has a finite verb in it. Okay. Moving on, guys, tell me what is a phrase. What do you think is a phrase? Idioms? No, they are not. Come on, what is a phrase? Have some examples in your head and then frame a definition for me. A small group of words standing together. Okay. It adds meaning to the sentence. Okay. It does not have proper meaning. Okay. Very good. It does not make complete sense. Okay. Great. Super. Okay. Now listen to this. As I told you, sentence, it makes complete sense. Phrase is a group of words that makes some sense, but not complete sense. It's not a predicate, guys. It is different. Phrase, it has some sense, okay, but not complete sense. Now if I tell you in the garden, now in the garden is phrase, but kya in the garden, ma'am? Kya matlab in the garden kya? Ye sentence to nahi ho sakta na, because it does not have a complete meaning. All right, so it adds meaning to the sentence, but it is not a complete idea. On the mat, under the table, to the headmaster, something like that. Okay, let us see. All my dear children, so very sweet. very happy with his work after a very long walk. All of these, they tell you something, but you don't get the entire meaning of it. Okay? Very clear with this? Okay. Now we come on to what is a clause. Okay? No, guys, a phrase is not a dependent clause. It is not. There's a difference between them. There's a very major difference between a dependent clause and a phrase. Okay? Let us see. To understand what a clause is, you only need to remember one word. Okay, that word is finite verb. So, a clause is a group of words containing compulsory one finite verb. I repeat, a clause is a group of words containing compulsory one finite verb. छोड़ दो कि वो सेंस बनता है कि नहीं बनता, बट इट शुड हैव वन फाइनाइट वर्ब. वेरी क्लियर विद दिस? ओके, सो सेंटेंस था, इट मेक्स कंप्लीट सेंस एंड इट हैज अ फाइनाइट वर्ब. ओके, फ्रेज इट डज नॉट हैव कंप्लीट मीनिंग एंड इट डज नॉट हैव एनी वर्ब्स इन इट, नो फाइनाइट वर्ब्स इन इट. ओके, a clause is a group of words that contains one finite verb. Very clear with this? Write it down somewhere. Okay. Let us see the example. Here is the book. Okay. Is there a finite verb in this one? Is. Very good. Next, now only look at the second part, okay, which is placed on the table. Which is placed on the table. Please tell me the finite verb there. Is placed. Is and placed nahi beta. Is placed pura. फाइनाइट वर्ब है. ठीक है, वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. ओके, सो इन द फर्स्ट पार्ट हियर इज द बुक. आई हैव अ कंप्लीट सेंस. ओके, हियर इज द बुक, इधर बुक है, तो इट मेक्स कंप्लीट सेंस टू मी एंड इट हैज अ फाइनाइट वर्ब, सो इट इज अ क्लॉज. इट इज ऑल्सो अ सेंटेंस एंड इट इज अ क्लॉज. ओके, in the next part, which is placed on the table. Now, when you look at it independently, okay, which is placed on the table. Now, here it has a finite verb, is placed. Okay, but I cannot understand the complete meaning of it. Right? Even then, it is a clause. Very clear with this? Yes, and on the table becomes your phrase. But right now, we are not focusing on that. Very clear with this? Okay, moving on. Beta, is placed finite verb isliye hua kyunki I can have a subject before that. It is placed. So, it, it. Instead of which, I can have it is placed. Okay? All right, moving on. Now, how to identify? Okay, I forgot one very important thing. Since we have learned clauses, how many clauses are there? Come on, how many clauses are there? Five, two, three. Okay. Which are the three, which are the five? Come on, tell me. Kitne clauses hote hai? Guys, there are only two clauses. There are only two clauses. We have our main clause एंड वी हैव सबऑर्डिनेट क्लॉज. आपको जो थ्री जो है माइंड में या फाइव है वो इनकरेक्ट है. जो नाउन नाउन क्लॉज, एडजेक्टिव क्लॉज, एडवर्ब क्लॉज है वो एक्चुअली क्या है, सबऑर्डिनेट नाउन क्लॉज, सबऑर्डिनेट एडजेक्टिव क्लॉज एंड सबऑर्डिनेट एडवर्ब क्लॉज, विच मीन्स दे आर द टाइप्स ऑफ सबऑर्डिनेट क्लॉजेस. करेक्ट. बट हाउ मेनी क्लॉजेस डू वी हैव? वी हैव ओनली टू क्लॉजेस, मेन क्लॉज एंड द सबऑर्डिनेट क्लॉज. नाउ मेन क्लॉज और द सेकेंड नेम दैट वी हैव इज इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज. नाउ एज द नेम सजेस्ट, इंडिपेंडेंट है, इट डज नॉट डिपेंड एनीवन फॉर इट्स मीनिंग. We have our subordinate clause or independent clause. Subordinate clause or dependent clause. It means that it is dependent on the main clause for its meaning. Very clear with this? Okay, so main clause and subordinate clause. We have two clauses, main and subordinate, independent and dependent. I repeat, independent and dependent. Okay, now moving on. How are you going to identify the main clause and the subordinate clause? There's three steps to do so. All right, I repeat, there are three steps to identify your main and subordinate clause. Let us look at them. The step one, identify the two finite verbs in your sentence and make sure both of them are different. Okay. So, first, identify the two finite verbs. Second, identify the subordinators. Now, what are subordinators? What are subordinators, guys? Don't give me example. And because, while, although I say examples, kaise de sakte ho? What are subordinators? Helping words, nahi? Okay, listen to this. Conjunctions are divided into two types. Conjunctions are divided into two types, coordinators and subordinators. Correct? Subordinators are words by which your subordinate clause begins. Okay. Very clear with this? Yeah. So, list of subordinators. We have a very good acronym for that. Let us learn it. Very easy. How to remember these subordinators. How to remember the conjunctions. Okay. Why this kolavariti? Why this kolavariti? Now, how? WHY, you have to remember all the WH words. Okay, why, when, where, what, who, whom, whose, how, all of these words, okay? TH, this. Okay, this matlab TH. TH, all the TH words. So, that, so that, than, more than, though, although, as though, all of these words are your TH conjunctions. Now, CO meaning condition conjunctions. Now, what are condition conjunctions? If, unless, whether, and had. Now, had is not very usually used, but if. Now, what is condition? So, if you pass this examination, I will give you a mobile phone. So, what is the condition to get you a mobile phone? You have to pass this examination. So, if you pass this examination, so it is a condition. So, your condition conjunctions are if, unless, and whether. Okay. R says reason conjunctions. It is, there is a very, very simple way to remember this. SAB, sub TV. So, SAB, since, as, because. Okay. Since, as, and because. Last one. T says the time conjunctions. So, all the conjunctions which are related to time. Before, after, till, until, since, once, ye sare words aa gaye, theek hai? So why it is Kolavadi? TYWH, TH, condition, reason, and time. This is how you remember the list of subordinators. Okay. Coming back to the main part. If you want to separate the main clause and the subordinate clause, you want to identify the main and the subordinate clause, what are you going to do? First of all, you are going to identify the two finite verbs that are present in your sentence. Okay. Second part, you will also identify the subordinator which is present. And to remember what subordinators are, the list is given to you. Okay. We will revise it again and again. So I'm very sure you will understand what I'm telling right now. Don't worry about that. Let us see step three. Step three is obviously separate the main clause and the subordinate clause in such a way that both of them should have one finite verb, because that is the basic condition to do so. Okay. When can I say that this is a main clause? जब ही उसके पास एक अपना फाइनाइट वर्ब होना चाहिए, क्योंकि क्लॉज का डेफिनेशन क्या था? A group of words that contain one finite verb. So if it is a main clause, it doesn't matter if it is a main clause or a subordinate clause, but each one of them should have its own finite verb. Am I clear to you till here? Yes or no, guys? Is this very, very clear to you? Okay. Now, the placement of the main clause and the subordinate clause is very easy. Okay. Sabse pehle bahut easy hai. Understand, it's really very easy. Subordinate clause, as the name suggests, it begins with a subordinator. Subordinate clause kidhar se begin hota hai? Subordinator se. तो जहां से भी सबॉर्डिनेटर आपको दिखता है वो पार्ट से सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज पक्का बिगिन होता है, ऑलवेज. दिस इज योर थंब रूल. ओके. एंड एज द नेक्स्ट पार्ट दैट आई टोल्ड यू के दोनों फाइनाइट वर्ब्स अलग अलग होने चाहिए. ओके. नाउ समटाइम्स क्या होता है, पहले मेन क्लॉज आता है, उसके बाद सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज आता है, करेक्ट. कभी कभी सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज पहले आता है, मेन क्लॉज उसके बाद आता है. एंड द थर्ड टाइप, द लास्ट टाइप इज दैट कभी कभी वड़ा पाव क्लॉज आ जाता है. वड़ा पाव क्लॉज मतलब क्या? आगे पीछे मेन क्लॉज, बीच में सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज. क्या बेटा? आगे पीछे मेन क्लॉज, बीच में सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज. सो देयर इज मेन क्लॉज प्लस सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज प्लस मेन क्लॉज. वेरी वेरी क्लियर विद दिस? नाउ लेट अस लुक एट दोस एग्जांपल्स. ओके. Okay, let us see this one. I hope that India wins the World Cup. Here I have to identify the main and the subordinate clause. Your step one is identify the finite verbs. Come on. Identify the finite verbs in this sentence. Very good. Hope and wins. होप के पहले आई है, विंस के पहले इंडिया है. वेरी गुड. सो आई हैव टू फाइनाइट, सॉरी, आई हैव टू फाइनाइट वर्ब्स. ओके. स्टेप टू, आइडेंटिफाई द सबॉर्डिनेटर. वेरी गुड गाइस, दैट वेरी गुड, दैट इज योर सबॉर्डिनेटर. वेरी गुड. Now, what do we have to do? Separate the main clause and the subordinate clause. मैंने क्या बोला था? Subordinate clause किधर से begin होता है? Subordinator से. तो that आपका subordinator है. Okay. तो that India wins the World Cup is your subordinate clause. I hope is your main clause. You just have to make sure that main clause के पास finite verb है और subordinate clause के पास भी उसका अलग से फाइनाइट वर्ब है. वेरी क्लियर विद दिस? सो देयर इज अ मिस्टेक हियर. वेरी क्लियर विद दिस. आई होप मेन क्लॉज दैट इंडिया विंस द वर्ल्ड कप सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज. इज देयर एनी डाउट्स हियर? आर देयर एनी डाउट्स हियर? ओके ग्रेट. सो हियर दिस वॉज एग्जाम्पल वन वेयर पहले मेन क्लॉज था उसके बाद सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज था. लेट अस मूव ऑन. सेकेंड वन, वेयर सीता वेंट वॉज अ मिस्ट्री. Where Sita went was a mystery. Come on, it's simple. Identify the two finite verbs here. Two finite verb. Very good. Went and was. There's a mistake here, definitely. Correct. Okay. What is your subordinate clause? Okay. So where is your subordinator? Subordinate clause is subordinate. Sorry. Subordinator se subordinate clause begin hota hai. Am I very clear with this one? So it will begin from here. And it will end here because I have to separate. I will break it here because I want the finite verbs to be different, right? To be in different clauses. So where Sita went is your subordinate clause. Was a mystery. It was a mystery is your main clause. Okay. It was a mystery main clause. Where Sita went is subordinate clause. Clear? Okay. Third one, last one. Let us see and then finish it off here. The movie that we saw was fantastic. Please identify the two finite verb. Very good. Saw and was. Correct? Two finite verbs, different. Which is the subordinator, second step, subordinator, that, very good, that is the subordinator. So, ऐसा हो सकता है क्या? The movie main clause आ सकता है क्या? The movie main clause? नहीं, क्योंकि main clause के लिए finite verb तो होना चाहिए ना. Okay, so what will I do? I will give the second finite verb to the main clause, correct? To make it a main clause. So the movie was fantastic. I will break it here. The movie was fantastic, main clause. That we saw, it's incorrect here. Hai na? That we saw is a subordinate clause. So it's a vada pav clause. पहले मेन क्लॉज, फिर दैट वी सॉ सबॉर्डिनेट क्लॉज, वॉज फैंटास्टिक मेन क्लॉज का पार्ट है. ओके, सो योर वी एंड द लेक्चर. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड. प्लीज रिवाइज इट थरली एंड वी विल कंटिन्यू दिस बिट. ओके, सो इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क इट टू मी इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. ओके, आई नो यू हैव अ लेक्चर नाउ, सो टेक केयर, स्टे सेफ, गुड बाय.